the greatest prime minister to have ever lived. Born in Ontario in 1874, he led Canada through the Second World War. Toronto, Chicago, Harvard, and London, schools King attended and earned his degrees from. A spiritualist, yeah, he talked to the dead, never married, but still went for what he wanted. The person he looked up to was Sir Wilfrid Laurier. He hoped that he could be that kind of leader someday. Then he was elected in 1921. He served till 26, then won the election. The next term would last until 1930, but then he lost that run and things got pretty ugly. He got back on his high horse in 1935. It ended in 48, 2 years before he died. Now he's sitting on the comfy $50 bill for all the stuff he did up on Parliament Hill. Let's start up at the top, yeah, I'm talking about the sky. The Royal Canadian Air Force started in 39. New Zealand, Australia, and also the UK brought money to Canada so their pilots could train. Prime Minister King then took advantage of their need. He wouldn't have to send Canadian soldiers overseas to fulfill the promise that Canada had made to support the British if they kept calling one day. So they started the BCATP to train the air forces of these three countries. Stationed in Canada during World War II, schools trained pilots, navigators, and air gunners too. 131,553, the number of graduates from the RFC. I'm sorry, RFC means Royal Flying Corps. They later changed that name to the Royal Air Force. The decision made by King when he turned 65 is a choice that keeps the dreams of Canadians alive. Want to fight for their country or maybe fly a plane? Prime Minister King gave them a place to train. King gave us an air force that's even called Royal, and he managed to do it on Canadian soil. Next up we go to 1927, the year that William King introduced the pension. It was a solution to try and solve poverty. It was for the Canadians who were over 70. This money would go to the people who retired, the ones who worked hard since the first time they were hired. The pensions that are paid to all our grandparents, the money that they get and they can start spending on having some fun with their grandkids too, spoiling those they love and making it through. And all of these things they have King to thank for he was the prime minister who opened that door. Now Prime Minister King, he was a nice guy, didn't leave the unemployed with nothing to get by. So many lost their jobs during the Great Depression. It took people a while to get over that recession. Then people were scared that there would be a repeat. King knew that they were scared, he knew, cause so was he. He made sure that unemployed insurance was released based on willingness to work and previous careers. Prime Minister King, he took care of his people. Finding someone like him like searching haystacks for a needle. Family allowance was another big step. Prime Minister King had wanted to help the families that were affected by the war and suffered because their wages were not up to par. With inflation and feeding their families, they had not been prepared for this calamity. It ended up improving the standard of life. King managed to prevent a world of strife. It is what we prevent rather than what we do that counts most in the government, he said, and followed through. He completely renewed the system of social welfare. A leader like King is extremely rare. Questioning which leader should win, just take a little look at Prime Minister King. 22 years, he served the longest time. I guess that means that he did something right. Fixed the social welfare and gave us an air force. He led Canada through the Second World War. So if anyone should win this history game, then William Lyon Mackenzie King is his name.
And feeling on this question, because the people of Canada have taken their full share of the load of providing relief and assistance for the war-shattered countries of Europe. True. Through mutual aid, through military relief, through UNRWA, as well as through direct governmental credits of over $500 million for the continent of Europe. I can speak for the government, of which during these years I have been the head.